ไม่รู้สึกGuys, welcome back to another episode of Joyous Fishing. So it's last light right now, and we are at Punggol Waterfront. Yep. So the bait for today is live prawn and kelong sotong. Yeah, we just got set up. The last light bite, unfortunately, has been pretty poor. Yeah, I know it looks quite bright on screen, but it's actually almost dark already. Yeah. So. We'll see how things go. Update you guys again later.
Hell, it's bloody toss up.
Oh. Oh, big one, huh?
So that was a tosat or catfish. Okay, I don't have much time to film now because it's our last light rush. Yeah, so what this means is that we are experiencing a last light bite. It came actually slightly later. Now it's like going to be dark. Yeah, it's later than expected. Yeah, so anyway, that was a tosat or catfish. Hokkien we call tosat. Yeah, in Malay we call sembilang. Yeah, so that's the eel-tail catfish. Okay, the reason why I was so disappointed was because today I wanted to film a video about tips and tricks on catching snapper. Right, but I thought that was a snapper, but it wasn't a snapper. So I was quite disappointed. Okay. Anyway, never mind. I'll just give you the first tip to catching snapper. Hopefully, I can show you all a snapper later. Hopefully. Okay, I really don't know, but I'll try. Okay. So anyway, tip 1 for snapper fishing, okay, is terrain. Right, so snapper usually when they are about 1 to 2 kilo, they like to school around sandy terrain. Yeah, so a place where there is a lot of sand where they can root around at the bottom for worms, for crabs, for different types of prey. Yeah, so fun fact. This kind of terrain is also home to catfish. Yeah, like the one I just caught. Yeah, so hopefully later I can show you that they share the same habitat lah. Yeah, hopefully. Okay, but anyway, I'll just film this first. Okay, and I'll need to go and rebait soon. Okay, so the first thing you all should know is terrain. Yeah, snapper like sandy terrain. Alright, so I'll go and rebait my lines. Hopefully we get more bites before last night is over. And yeah, we'll update you guys again later. Okay, something just ran off with our ultra light setup.
Risky ah, this one.
No, just slowly play I think got enough line on.
Jahan ah, this one.
Yeah, probably Jahan. Yeah,
this one
Jahan. Yeah, looks like. But so fun ah.
Yeah lah, this man for Jahan.
Wow, look at the band.
Now on this line. Now on this line.
Am I? Okay, Ang Zhuo. Oh my gosh, Ang Zhuo. Okay, that is a little bit tricky. How are you going to bring this out? This line, how many pounds? don't want to reach there.
Any catch?
Yeah, there's
small
stepper. Small stepper.
You're a subscriber, by the way.
Oh, thank you. Hello.
Light lines,
yeah. Yeah,
sir.
How big is the stepper?
1 kilo? I think got 1 kilo. I think got
less than one.
Maybe less, yeah. 800. Wow, check. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to gaff the fish because our line is a bit too light.
I'm not sure how many pounds this line actually.
It's probably 8 to 15. Our ultra line never go above here, usually. Yeah, anyway, we just gaff low. Okay, it's not that big. I think it's 31 only from detail, barely 31. But problem is that I hit it with the gaff, even though the gaff didn't sink in. Yeah, so I hit it like 4 times. So I think I'm just going to clean it up. Yeah, because I'm not sure where I hit it though. I think I hit in the body. You can see the scales. Yeah. So anyway, we'll clean this and yeah, keep fishing. Update you guys again later. Alright guys, so I just proved my point. Okay, that was John Snapper, okay, on our ultralight. Yeah, so unfortunately it was barely big enough for us to bring back, and I didn't really want to bring it back, but I hit it with the gaff. So yeah, I just cleaned it and brought it back. Yeah, so anyway, that proves my point. Snapper share the same habitat as catfish. Okay, yeah. Okay, it's a relief that we got that snapper. So now I can properly show y'all snapper fishing tips and tricks video. Okay. So the second tip for snapper fishing, okay, is that snapper are bottom feeders. Okay, so what they do, as I mentioned, I think previously, is that they root around in the sand and they create these like bowls, or like they gouge out holes in the sand when they dig for food. Yeah, so they always feed along the bottom of the seabed. Yeah, so what you want to do is to make sure that your bait isn't too far above the seabed. So usually what we do is we use double Apollos with one of the snoot usually very close to the bottom. Otherwise, we use a long snoot bottom feeder. Okay, so you can check out these two rig tying videos. We have it on our channel. Yeah, in case you're wondering how to tie them. Yeah, so snappers are bottom feeders. Yep, so that's tip number two. It's still currently last light 7-ish. So I'm going to rebait my lines again. Hopefully, we'll get something throughout the night. Yep, so update you guys again later. Alright guys, so sorry, the construction is a bit noisy. Yeah, so anyway, now that the last light bite or the last light rush is over, I have time to film some stuff. Right, so Singapore actually has quite a few different types of snapper, a few different species. Okay, the most common is of course the John snapper, Lugenus johnii or Ang Zor. So the second most common maybe will be the Russell snapper. They look very similar to the John snapper. Yeah, so it's a Lugenus russelli, we call Ang Zor Ki. Yep, and the third snapper that is kind of common, you probably see a lot maybe offshore or in the reef areas, is actually the Spanish flag snapper. So Lugenus caponotatus or Timun as we call it. Yeah, so these are the three most common. Other than that, there are the red snapper, Ang Kwe, mangrove jack, Chia Zor. Then there's also the mangrove snapper and the star snapper. Yeah, so Singapore has about 6 or 7 different species of snappers. Yeah. Anyway, what we... Oh my gosh. Woo! The Look at that, look at that, look at that. Oh my gosh.
Okay, so the fish managed to unsung cord la. And it say bring up Zhang Zhou.
Zhang Zhou. Oh my god.
Okay.
But it's like dead la, really. It's been there for a very very long time.
Mm.
I don't even think it's swimming.
It's sad, right?
Should I just
bring it up.
Yeah,
it's been sunk for don't know how long.
Oh, it's to a line, ah. Wow, this is a good size one. Wow, it's a lot of lines. Look at this.
This is golden.
But it's screwed. It's breathing lah, but rigor mortis.
The line for hours long, ah, what?
No, last time one.
It's dead.
No, it's not. It's still alive.
You can see, yeah, I brought a lot of brittle stars.
Yeah, together with all the line.
It's a
one big mass of line.
Yeah, very nice, lovely starfish. When let out. Yeah, all these are starfish. Huh? We're just going to let it go.
Oh,
this
one
really
golden.
Yeah, this is a golden.
That's why they call this golden sniffer.
This, yeah, specimen is really golden.
Yeah, it's really nice. Alright guys, back again. Okay, so we managed to get that snapper up. Okay, that was John Snapper, our second John Snapper for today. Now see, I can't even finish my drink. Only about halfway through. Keep drinking and fuming. Yeah. So anyway, it was quite lucky managed to get that one up. Yeah, I at first I thought it was a stingray, because it stop moving, then it like suck on the bottom. But afterwards, I realized it was a snack, so we stopped filming, and we were actually ready to lose the fish. But thankfully, it came back up. So, very long time. Yeah. So anyway, that was our second John snapper. That one was about 1 kilo plus, and we cleaned it. I just finished cleaning it. Yeah. So, anyway, tip number 3. Alright, for snapper fishing. Okay. Snapper. Wait. I eat my bubble tea. Okay, snapper are not so particular about the type of bait, but more particular about the freshness of your bait. Yeah. So what this means is that they feed on many many different types of bait. Worm, small fish, tamban, squid. I keep hearing a bell ringing. Squid, prawn, crabs, even sometimes those sea snails, mussels. Yeah, so snappers are not so fussy about the type of bait, but more of the freshness. So how fresh your bait is. That's why usually we use Kelong sotong or fresh dead prawn or else live prawn. Yeah. So Kelong sotong and fresh dead prawn, basically it means that the squid and the prawn have never touched fresh water before, as compared to market squid. Yeah, so they are fresher than market squid. Yeah, So which is why we use Kelong Sotong lah and fresh dead prawn rather than the market ones, even though we pay a lot more for it yeah, as compared to their market ones. Yep, so there is tip number 3? Yeah, 3, correct. Tip number 3. Okay, snapper prefer fresher bait in our experience. Of course, I know some people have caught them on like market prawn and kind of thing. Yes, I know. But in our experience, fresher bait works better for snapper. Yep, so anyway, we'll keep fishing. Update you guys again later. Okay, so something just took our surf caster rod. I think it's very big.
Maybe it's a
that is a blue spotted stingray, I think. Likely to be interesting. Wait, I don't think y'all can see it. My light a bit. Okay, y'all can see a bit. There. It's a blue spotted stingray. Oh, but 1 kilo, I think slightly less than 1 kilo. Yeah, anyway, I'll try to bring it up.
Oh, I thought Jahan.
I also thought Jahan. Okay. In the water look
yeah,
big only.
Yeah, the water look big Okay, not big.
The tail toe. Yeah, yeah, why is ya?
Something bite him. Confirm.
How? Who would bite a stingray?
I don't know. Something tried to
bite
him. Okay, this one is a female. Because here it doesn't have caspers. Yeah, so for males they will have two things. They are called caspers. The same habitat as snapper. Okay, anyway, go release him. Bye bye. Okay, so just caught another. Oh my god, am I filming? Yeah, I am. Okay, just caught another small stingray. Oh, that one is a
mangrove
big ray. Yeah, mangrove big ray. Okay, I'm gonna bring it up. Is this out? Like, no, it's not. Yeah, it's not. So this is a young male, yeah, as opposed to just now that blue spotted stingray, that was a female. Yeah, so anyway, oops. Very young, very nice. Okay, bye bye.
Sound gone so fast.
I'm talking. Okay, this is a Russell snapper or Angzorki. Yeah, so Lugenus Rasselli. Okay, the previous one was Angzor Lugenus Johnny. Yeah, so this one is actually a smaller species of snapper. They tend not to grow very big. Yeah, so you can actually tell the difference from the purplish. Okay, I don't know where you can see. Purplish color, slightly more tapered head. Yeah, wait, let me hold this. Yeah, okay, so you can see a purplish color along the belly and the tail.
then a slightly tapered, elongated head, yeah, and a yellow stripe going down. Yeah. Yep. So anyway, this it's actually quite one of the bigger angchokis that we've got around this place. Usually they are like very small. This one got like 30 cm, I think. Don't have 30 cm. About 20 cm.
Yep. Angchoki. Okay, or in never let go of the chenko. Malaysia they call ikan tanda. Yeah, so anyway, we're gonna release this. Bye bye. Alright guys, so that was our third snapper for today. Yeah, that was a Russell snapper or Ang Zorki, Lugenus Russelli. Yeah, or ikan tanda. Yeah, so anyway, we let that one go lah, we didn't really need it. And after that was two stingrays or pari. Yeah, so that proves my first point on terrain. Yeah, here is sandy terrain because stingrays, especially mangrove whipray, blue spotted stingray, white spotted stingray, they are all sandy terrain fish. Yeah, so it means that down here is sandy terrain lah. Okay. Yeah, so I think it's time for tip number 4. Okay, for tip number 4, snapper right, usually, especially the side of their head, is they have a very hard gill plates or operculum. Yeah, so if you go to the market or you catch a snapper, you try knocking on the cheek. It's a very 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 hard. Yeah, so what this got to do with fishing is that when you fish for snappers, leave your hook exposed. So leave the point of your hook exposed. Yeah. Otherwise, when the snapper take, if it's covered by the bait, there is a chance that they will not get hooked. Yeah, because their mouths are very very hard. Yeah, so what we do is that we leave the point of our hook exposed. Yeah, even when baiting. So I know some people like to hide the hook, but for snappers, usually what we find out is that they are not leader shy. Okay, leader shy basically means that, okay, for certain fish like talang, queenfish, they are leader shy. So if you use thick leader and big hook, they are less likely to take your bait or your lure. Yeah, so snapper, they don't really care. So you can use big hook, you can use thick leader, whatever, they will still eat your bait on. Yeah, so that's what we found out lah. So we tend to leave the hook point exposed so that it will hook in. Yeah, there's a higher chance that it will hook in. Yeah, so anyway, that is tip number 4, and we'll keep fishing, update you guys again later. Okay, so if you are curious about what I mean when I say leave the hook point sticking out, right, okay, here, hold on, focus there, hold on for a moment. Yeah, there, okay, yeah, you can see, right, the hook point is actually sticking out of the speed. Yeah, so that's what I mean when I, sorry, it's not very focused. Okay, but you all can roughly see here. Yeah, so that's what I mean when I say leave the hook point sticking out. Yeah, as well as for this one. Ooh. Yeah, you can see the hook point is coming out of the bait. Yep, so anyway, keep fishing, update you guys again later. Okay, so anyway, I'll just take this chance to update you. I was gonna show you the bell ringing, but it's not gonna ring anymore, so too bad. Okay, anyway, so gonna update you guys. Since the flathead has been pretty quiet, I don't know how well y'all can hear me now, so because I'm wearing my mask. And yeah, I finished my drink, so too bad I need to wear my mask. Yeah, hope y'all can hear me. It's been pretty quiet. We've been switching up between Kelong Sotong, live prawn, and a little bit of spare tamban that we have. Yeah, so anyway, we will keep on fishing for one more, I guess. Yep, and update you guys again later. Old friend.
Well, you know when I casted this, I felt something.
Immediately.
The feelings, yeah.
You want to fight this?
You fight, I think.
Ah, fight this. 像 old friend 你是不是没有买人家鞋子
taken 的100磅
不要那脏 fresh 的脏
finally comes out waiting
for yeah, really we wait the whole night for this
for the old friend
for the initial run really a lot after it's coming
after
in
after it's just swimming yeah.
then you can feel the the heat shake sounds so nice but I'm not asking you got 3-4 kilo I done my arm actually tired
what?
my arm actually tired cause just now the arm saw stuck like the arm saw stuck on the thing then we tight drag then pull them off
yeah.
oh, finally come this one please don't go into the other line.
My rod draw. The right side, the ultra light.
Oh yeah. Is it this one? You go inside this. Oh, don't like that. Old friend.
Oh,
I think got 5 eh. No way, you never kena any line 4, 5 got this one. Guys, so we are packing up right now, and I think that's about all the action for today. Yeah, so it was a pretty action-packed day lah. We have two John snapper, Ang Zo, one Russell snapper, Ang Zo Ki, two stingrays, one mango quick ray, one blue spotted stingray, one flathead, a couple of small usat, and one huge 4 kilo jahan. Yeah, which fell off the hook. So I'm kind of glad it fell off so I didn't have to muscle it up. Yeah. So anyway, it's a pretty good day and I think now is right for the last tip I have. Tip number 5, keep casting. Alright, so I'm sure many of you all have watched our videos. You all will wonder like, oh, why we so lucky, why we every time catch fish. So I guess if you all want to know, if you are interested, okay, we fish very very often. Okay. Depending on our schedule actually. So sometimes it can be like every day for one whole week, or sometimes it can be 2 weeks but one time, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah, so behind every video is actually a lot of hard work, a lot of sessions, many trips where we actually catch nothing. Yeah, so it's not really that we are very very lucky, but more like we keep going out to fish and keep giving ourselves the chance to get fish lah. Yeah, so anyway, keep casting. Okay, don't be too disheartened if you don't get your fish. Yeah, they will come lah eventually. When the time is right, they will come. Alright, so hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Hope you guys learned something. And yeah, thanks for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next episode. Bye!